today we're going to be replacing the anti-siphon valve. The anti-siphon valve keeps the boat from sinking when it's sitting still. If water comes back up the exhaust, this allows a little bit of air to go in and the water to go out instead of actually running back into the engine block or getting back in the boat. So I'm going to take this out. It's been leaking a little bit, salt water in here in this area, and I tested it and it seemed to be okay, but I'm not sure. So we'll take this out. Kind of lets the system burp, get a little air, and that keeps it from running back inside. So that's what the valve looks like. Now, unfortunately, the only valve I could find is this one. And this one works a little bit differently. It has like a, kind of like a hose pipe fitting on it. Looks all the same other than that, but it won't screw in, so I'm gonna have to take a brass fitting. I tried to find a plastic one. They didn't have one at Lowe's. We'll take a brass fitting and we'll screw it in here. Like so. Hope it's not going to be too tall where it won't go under the back up under the companionway steps. Hope not. Then we'll take this siphon valve and put it on here, and hopefully that's gonna all work. There it goes. I think it's starting now. Yeah. See if that's gonna close before I put it all in there. Seems to. Yep. Okay. Get some wrenches. Tighten that up good. And then we'll give it a test here in a little while and see what it does. So here it is. It's the anti-siphon valve after I finished it. All hooked up good and ran the engine for 43 minutes and it didn't leak. So there you go. Now I need to order a spare. So here's the dipstick out of the Yanmar. I have a KM 3A1. And you can see the way this thing is made is it has a hole right there for a vent. And it's hollow. Then it has a little piece it punches out of the top of it. And if you look at this, what happens is the threads break off. And then this thing can actually slide out like that, that tube. So there's a company that makes one that's aluminum. And the whole knob handle, the whole thing is aluminum, so it doesn't break. So I ordered it. So when it gets here, I'll tell you a little bit about it and where to get one, because from what I understand, this is a very common problem with the Yanmar and transmission combination, which is the KM 3s and 4s and different numbers. But anyway, I'll let you know how it goes when it gets here. Okay, here's what the new anodized dipstick looks like. And it's made by a company called Caribou Marine, and it worked absolutely perfectly. Today I'm going to be working on the fly screen for the ports. See this hinge? They break. And I got a couple of them that are like that that I need to replace. I have to look at all of them to see which ones is broke, and they won't stay on there. But anyway, they make a kit. This is kind of what the kit looks like. It's a Lumar hatch And if you look, you see it says fly screen spare for the hinges. There's the number. So I'm going to try to put this thing on and see. It comes with all kinds of parts. I don't think I need all those parts. But, you know, it doesn't hurt to have them. It's always good to have spares on the boat. Yeah, we all know that. So let's see how this goes.
Okay, the way this thing works, you can see the hinge right here is broke. And it unsnaps. And then there's another piece here that actually is the rest of the hinge. But you just take, you unclip it. See if I can do it one-handed. I don't know if I can. There you go. And it comes down like that. There's clips that holds it in.
And then, what they send you is they send you a new hinge. Now this hinge is made a little bit different. So it's a little bit narrower. And they also send you the piece that clips to the edge of the screen itself. So I'm going to see if I can get this down and get this one put on. See if I can get you where you can see. Show you how this works. So, okay, so this clip screen goes like this. And clip goes on. Then what we have to do is take this other one out. Now when we get this down, you can see that quite a bit wider than the other one. So we'll put this other one up. We'll see what it looks like. So let's see if I can get where you can see and all.
See that now? That's mounted. You should be able to take your screen. See, they have it on there upside down. Hey, there you go. Yeah, that's what it looks like after it's all put on there. So you should be able to just take these in there. And it should just hinge down like this. Then you can open your port and then there you go. And then hinge just right back up. Alright. Fixed. About three more to go.
Next week on Dreamweaver.
Okay, today we're going to be installing a scan strut. What the scan strut does is it mounts to the backstay and you're able to mount a radar dome on top of this scan strut that's attached to the backstay so you don't have to put it on the mast.